Respected dear family members, my pranams to you. Many people used to say Lord Krishna has got thousands and thousands of wives. In our stories, Puranas, it has been told that 16,000 and odd wives are there for Lord Krishna. But if you go deep into the Mahabhagavata or Mahabharata, you can see that Lord Krishna, of course, has got three, Satyabhama, Jambavati, Rukmini, three wives, whereas 16,000 number is arising from a story or history. You know Narakasura. You may be also knowing about Bhumasura, two asuras. Asura, Rakshasa means ordinary human being having demonic qualities or disqualifications. They are known as asuras, Asurika Shakti. They used to enjoy the women and used to put them in jail. Always put them in jail. And Narakasuras and Bhumasuras, mothers, requested their son not to do so. The sons did not obey that, so they approached Lord Krishna. And Lord Krishna requested, instructed them to release the women. But they did not follow. Lord Krishna fought with them. Narakasura Vadha and Bhumasura Vadha took place. Death or killing of these two asuras took place. And Lord Krishna released all the women in the jail. They happily came to their home, but their brothers, their husbands, their parents, and the general public citizens rejected them, did not accept them, because they lived in the jail of the asuras. So their name, fame went bad. So they came back to Lord Krishna and asked, "We are hungry, we want protection. Now we are in the roads." At that time, Lord Krishna took the decision to give them the status of the queens, Rajapatni, Krishna Patni status. Not that he married all the 16,000. He gave the status of his wife to all these women. They got very fast absorbed in the society, their family members accepted them. Similar thing happened in China in 1949. When Mao Zedong released all the women from the jail, the family members, the relatives of these women, they never accepted these women. At that time, Mao Zedong gave them a certificate known as National Women Status Certificate. With that certificate, people can marry these women. They will be getting social protection. They will be getting jobs, employment reservation. Social status got elevated for these women. Thus, within 2 years, these women got absorbed in the society. What Lord Krishna did in Dwapara Yuga, same thing repeated in China by Mao Zedong, and he could get the social acceptance for the women who were there in the jail. Thus, we can see that Lord Krishna never had 16,000 wives. He had one or two or three, just like any other kings during that period. And remember that this story of the Narakasura or Bhumasura may be history or historical story. Still, we should understand one man cannot afford 16,000 wives. Even though Aurangzeb, Shah Jahan, Akbar, they had so many wives. Tipu Sultan also had so many wives. And 11 wives were there for Prophet Muhammad. At the age of 57, Prophet Muhammad had 11-year-old wife also. But Lord Krishna's case is entirely different. He gave the status of his wife, Krishna Patni status, to the people, to the women who got released from the jail for social acceptance. You should learn this one and you should inform others. Thank you very much. My pranams to you.